Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm starting off a really, really exciting series. I'm going to be doing a makeup declutter for 2018. You guys absolutely loved it when I did it last year, so I thought I'd bring it back because I've been decluttering my room the past couple of weeks and makeup was the next on my list. So I thought I would share it with you because I really enjoyed doing it and yeah, I think that you'd find it interesting as well. I'm going to be splitting up the series into three different videos. I'm going to be doing my face products, my eye products, and my lip products. And today's is my face products. So I'm going to be going through my primers, concealers, foundations, highlights, blushes, bronzers, all of that sort of thing. And yeah, just bring you along with me and show you what I'm keeping and what I'm decluttering. All of the things I'm decluttering will either be going in the bin if it's expired or I just can't use anymore, or it'll be going to family and friends as well. So it's all going to good use. I just prefer other people to use the makeup that I don't use because they might as well get some love out of it. Also, I'm going to be filming this series on my vlogging camera just because it's so much easier to prop up and to just get the right position so you can see everything that I'm doing. So I'm sorry if the quality is less of my proper main camera, but yeah, I just thought it would be more like chatty and more natural. So yeah, I think it would be something a little bit different as well. So this is the current state of my acrylic storage. All of these drawers are from Beautify. I'm pretty sure that if you just type in acrylic storage on Amazon, they'll come up because that's where I got mine from. And as you can see, it's very jam-packed. And I'm going to be going through five of these drawers today, which are the bottom two on this one, and then the bottom three on this other side. And then I'm not gonna lie, guys, I have all of this stuff over here, which doesn't actually fit in the drawers. It's just like overspill, so that all needs to go in there as well once it's all decluttered. And yeah, I'm just going to show you everything like drawer by drawer as well, so it's just easier to follow. And I will show you a before of all of the drawers just so you can see like before and after to get a true picture of everything that I'm going to be decluttering. So I'm just going to get started because I feel like this video is going to be a very long one, but I really hope that you enjoy the series. And yeah, I'm excited to get started. Okay, so I'm just going to start off by opening all the drawers that I'm going to be decluttering today just so you can see a before of every single one. So if I move the camera, I'm trying to find a good angle. Let me try and put the camera down a little bit. I feel like that's a better angle, possibly. We're gonna work with that. Okay, so the first drawer I have is my primers and concealers, if I can get it out without dropping all of the other drawers. And then the next drawer is foundations. And then the drawer above this one is my highlights and contour products, I'm pretty sure. And then over this side, I have all of my bronzers and powders. And then finally, I have all of my blushes in this drawer. Okay, so these are all of the drawers out. It's really hard to show you a proper before just because they're all like stacked on top of each other, but I hope that this gives you a sense of how much stuff there is. Let's just deal with it one by one. I feel like that's the best way to go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take each drawer separately. I'm going to take everything out of the drawer and pop it on to this sheet thing which I've got here, and then I'm going to get a box which is for my decluttered stuff, and then everything that I'm going to keep I'll put on the other side. And I'm also going to clean the drawers as well, and then once I've decluttered everything that I want to from that drawer, I'll put it all back in and show you it all reorganized. So let's just get started. Okay, so I'm going to start with my concealers and primers drawer, and I'm just going to take everything out of here, put it onto this blank space here, and then just clean out the drawer and get it ready to declutter. So I've got my pile here, got my declutter box here, and then everything that I'm going to keep, I'm just literally going to put to one side. So let's just get started. I'm not going to do any order. I'm literally just going to delve in. So the first thing I have here is my number 7 Airbrush Away Primer. I absolutely love this. It's one of my all-time favourite primers. So 100% I am keeping that one. And then next I have this Autograph Hydrating Confidence Boost Primer. I haven't actually given this a go, so I'm going to keep it so I can test it out and then, yeah, see whether I like it or not. And then next I have this Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer Sample. I don't think I'm going to use this just because it is so small, so I am going to declutter that one. And then next I have this Revolution Ultra Face Base Primer. I also don't use this, so I will declutter this one as well. And then next I have this Maybelline Instant Anti-Age Eraser Eye Concealer. I never really use this because it is quite orangey and a bit dark, so I'm going to pass that one along as well, and it is quite old, so... And then next I have this Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. There's honestly like nothing left in this, so I am gonna just get rid of it because there's the tiniest amount left. And then I have a load of collection concealers, which I'm just gonna go through and see which ones are full and which ones are empty. And then I'll get back to you and tell you which ones I'm gonna be keeping, because I'm not even joking. There's literally about 10 of them here, so I don't wanna bore you with showing you every single one because they're all the same, but I just honestly love them so, so much. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to group together the different colors. So I have a load of fair ones, and then I have more medium ones. I have cool medium. I just have a range of different shades. So I'm just gonna put together all the same shades and then decide which ones I'm gonna keep out of those. Okay, so I got rid of four, and then these are the ones that I'm keeping. I've got three in the shade fair, two in cool medium, and then one in warm medium. And yeah, I just use this concealer on an everyday basis. I pretty much use no other, so it kind of makes sense that I've got so many of these and they need to be used up. So I'm gonna keep the ones that have the most product in. And then I also have this Makeup Revolution, what is this actually called? The Conceal and Define Concealer. I've only just got this and I haven't given it a go yet, so of course I'm gonna be keeping that. That's in the shade C2. What else do I have? I'm gonna be passing along this Rimmel Match Perfection Concealer. I've had this for ages, I never wear it. Same with this Miss 41. I really, really like this concealer, but it is really old, so I don't think it's worth me keeping it just because I just don't use it. And then what else do I have? Okay, so I'm gonna keep this NYX Color Correcting Concealer Kit, just because I've never tried a color correcting kit and I want to give it a go and see if it's worth like having it. So I'm going to give it a go, and if I don't use it soon, then I will declutter that one as well. And then I just have this Freedom Pro Studio Strobe Cream. Again, I haven't given this much of a go, so I might keep it for now. And then I have the Body Shop All-in-One Insta Blur. I don't think there's much left in this, so I'm going to pass this one along as well. And the same with this Nivea Primer. I never use this. And then of course I'm going to be keeping my Nivea Men Pro Shave Balm. This is honestly a godsend. It's so, so good. It helps your makeup just stick to your face. And if you haven't tried it, definitely try it. I know it sounds a bit weird, but it's a good life hack, so definitely try that. And then the last few things are just some more primers. So I have this Benefit They Don't Stray primer. This is like an eyelid kind of primer. It's for concealer and eyeshadow, I'm pretty sure, but it's practically run out. But I did really like it though, so I would definitely recommend it. But yeah, as you can see, it is a really small size. And then I'm gonna be keeping this Pure Correcting Primer. Again, I haven't given this much of a go, so definitely keeping that. And then of course I'm just gonna be keeping the Benefit Professional. Again, I really haven't given this much of a go, just because I just have so many different primers that I just always tend to go for. And because it's high end, I tend to not use it because I'm scared I'm gonna use it up, but I'm gonna start using it and giving it a go, and I'll let you know what I think of it if I'm really enjoying it. So I'm gonna get rid of the travel version, just because if I have the big one, I don't need this little one. And then I have the Maybelline Baby Skin. I'm not sure how much is left in this. Let me just check. There's not much left in it and it is quite old, so I think I'm gonna declutter that one as well. Okay, so these are all the things I've decluttered so far. I think I've done a pretty good job because there's a lot of things in here, and then these are all the things that I'm keeping. And I'm now gonna put it all back into the acrylic storage and show you what it looks like after. Okay, so this is what the final drawer looks like. I think this is such a big difference. Like, honestly, I'm so happy with this, and I feel like it's just showing you all the products that I love and that I use. There's no point keeping products that I'm just not going to use and not going to like. And yeah, I'm really, really happy with how it's going so far. I hope we can continue to do this well, and yeah, this is the first drawer done. Okay, so next is my foundation drawer. I'm going to do exactly the same, put it all on to this empty space, clean the drawer and start decluttering. Okay, so this is the pile of before. I have a lot of foundations. I'm a bit of a hoarder, so this drawer honestly just needs so much done to it. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add everything that I'm decluttering into this box again, and just add it to these products as well, just because, yeah, I might as well make a big pile of declutter stuff. So let's just get started and go through all of these. It's a bit daunting, but I feel like we're gonna do it. We're gonna do well. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my favorite foundation, which is the L'Oreal True Match. And I think I have three of these. Let me just check. Yeah, okay, so I think this is all of them. So the shade that I wear on an everyday basis is 3D Golden Beige, and I just absolutely love this foundation. This is why I don't know why I have so many other foundations, because I never use them, because this is the only thing I use. So I'm gonna keep both of these, because I think this one on the left is new and then this one on the right is the current one I'm using, so of course I've got to keep both of them. And then I also have this one, which is in the shade Creamy Beige. It's a little bit lighter than the others, so I think I'm gonna keep this one as well, just because if I am a little bit paler, then this is going to be a good one to go for. And of course it is my favorite, so I can't really part with it. And then next I have a L'Oreal Infallible Sculpt Contouring Base. I don't really get this product because it is a foundation, but it was part of the Sculpt collection and I just never wear it. So I think I'm going to pass this one along now, because if I don't wear it, I'm not going to ever wear it. And then I also have this L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Foundation. This foundation I do really like, but it is really pale. This is the palest shade they do. I think I'm going to keep it for now and then assess the situation once I've gone through all the other foundations. But I do really like it, and if I mix it with some of the darkening drops, it might work. So for now, this one's going in the keep pile. And then as I just mentioned, I have the Body Shop Darkening Drops. I really like these because it just... it's so much easier to change your foundation shade, and it means you don't have to buy a new foundation, because whenever I change shade, I don't know about you, but I don't want to buy a whole new foundation because I feel like that's just such a waste of money. So the fact that I have the lightning drops and the darkening drops from the Body Shop, I just have to keep these because they are a godsend, honestly. I'm pretty sure this one has run out, so I will declutter this one just because I don't need two of them when this one's practically empty. So yeah, that one will be going in there. And then next I have the Rimmel Match Perfection. This was my second foundation that I ever wore, I'm pretty sure. I think the first one was the Bourjois Healthy Mix Serum, and then this was the second one I bought. And this was just my all-time favourite. I wore it all the time before I discovered L'Oreal True Match, and I do really like it, but I just never wear it and it is really old. So I think I'm gonna get rid of this one, and if I ever want it again, I will just repurchase it. But it is a really good starter foundation, so I definitely recommend this as well. And then next I have the L'Oreal Infallible Total Cover. Again, I just don't wear this. I absolutely love L'Oreal foundations, as you can probably tell by my other picks. But this one, I just don't know, because it is a tube foundation and I just don't really get on well with tube foundations, especially because they're so matte. So I think I will pass this one along as well, just because I just don't wear it. And then next I have this CoverGirl Outlast All Day Stay Fabulous foundation. This is a 3-in-1. It's a foundation, a sunscreen, and also a SPF 20. And I did get this in America. I haven't given this a go yet, so I'm definitely keeping this. And yeah, I'm excited to give it a go. And then next, again, I have another American foundation. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I'm pretty sure I used this in my Instagram followers choose my makeup tutorial video. I think I did anyway, so definitely check that out if you want to see this in action. But it is really good and I do like it, so of course I'm keeping that one as well. And I have only just got them, so there's no point in me getting rid of them. And then next I have this Body Shop All-in-One BB Cream. I never wear this and it is really, really old. I don't think there's much left in it either, so definitely getting rid of that one. And the same goes for this Miss Sporty one. This is the Mission Correction Multi-Action Foundation. It's a concealer, foundation, and highlighter. I think I got this for a drugstore video. I just don't wear it, so there's no point me keeping this one either. And then these samples I will get rid of as well, because I just don't see the point of these really small samples. I feel like you need like a pot or something, because this is not gonna fill my face. Like, honestly, do they want me to just do a cheek of foundation? Like, I just don't get it. So yeah, gonna get rid of those as well, because I'm never gonna use them. And then I do also have a couple of powders in here, because they didn't fit in my powder drawer, because yeah, it's just all so jam-packed in these drawers, and why I needed this declutter. But I think I'm gonna keep both of these. I think they're both full. Let me just check. And I have the shades 225 Beige and also 160 Sand Beige. Did I say what these were? These are the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Powders. This is my everyday powder, so definitely going to keep both of them, and hopefully once my bronzer and powder drawer is cleared out, I can fit these in there. And then I have two of the Rimmel Wake Me Up foundation. I don't really use this foundation either, but I think I'm going to keep the ivory one just in case I do want to use it. Let me just check the stuff left. Okay, there is stuff left, so I'm going to keep this one and then declutter the light porcelain, because it is too light for me. And yeah, this is a really good summer foundation though, so if you're looking for something that is a bit lighter and it does have a lot of like glittery highlighting particles in it, so it is really pretty, then this is a good one to go for as well. And then next I have the Rimmel Lasting Finish. I used to love this as well, and I still do, but I just don't wear it, so I'm going to declutter this one as well, and it is pretty old, so yeah, going to declutter that one. And then the final foundation I have is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow. Again, I got this in America, and I haven't given it a go yet, and I have heard really good things, and I feel like out of all true foundations, these sort of ones are the ones that I go for, just because they're not completely matte, so definitely keeping that. Okay, so this is what my declutter box now looks like. It is pretty full, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, it's gone out of focus. There we go. Okay, so yeah, as you can see, it is pretty full now, and these are all the ones that I'm keeping. And as I said, I'm gonna try and put these in the powder drawer when I get to it.
But I feel like I've done such a good job here as well, because I just had so many foundations that I never wore. So the fact that I've got the bare few, even like this is quite a lot for some people, but the fact that I've cut it down so much is just so good. So I'm going to put this back into the drawer and show you what it looks like after. Okay, so this is what the drawer looks like now. I'm honestly just so happy with how this is going, and yeah, it just looks so much better and so much neater. So I'm really, really proud of myself, and yeah, I just love all these foundations. So if you are looking for recommendations, then definitely give these ones a go.
So the next drawer I have is all of my contour products and my highlighting products. I have a few over in this other section over here as well. So once I've got all of these out, I will put the ones in that pile into this pile and just put them all together. And again, just take it all out, clean the tray, and then I will show you what I'm decluttering.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure this is the biggest pile of products I'm gonna have. Like, honestly, this is such a joke. I just have a bit of an addiction to contour and highlight. Like, it's just something that I feel like a lot of people have, but I clearly do have it as well. And yeah, I don't even know where to begin. Like, this is gonna be so difficult. And this declutter box is already getting quite full. So yeah, this could be interesting. Let's just get started.
So I'm gonna start with two palettes that I've got from Freedom. These are the Pro Stro palette, and I have the cream version, which is this one. And I also have the just usual version, which is the, if I can open it, just the powder one. And I'm not gonna lie, I never ever reach for these, and they are good if you're looking for a like contour palette, but I just never really use that. I just tend to use a single contour shade, so I'm probably just gonna pass these along because there's no point me having them, and they are really big, so they do take up a lot of room. So yeah, I'm gonna put them in my declutter pile. And then I also have this Revolution highlight palette. Again, I just don't use this because I just have so many others that I just love. I thought this is a really good beginner's palette though, just because it has three different shades and it kind of has everything you need, but I just don't use it. So yeah, I'm gonna pass that one along as well to someone else that will use it. And then next I have my NYX Strip of Genius highlight palette, and this one I absolutely love and always use. It's a really, really good one actually, and yeah, I would definitely prefer this over the other ones, so I'm definitely going to keep that. And also, you're getting so many more shades in this for the money, so yeah, definitely recommend this. And then I also have the SOAP X Revolution highlight palette, again a really, really nice one, and you're getting so many shades, so I would probably recommend this more for a beginner, just because I think this is £8, was it? So that means they're just £1 a shade, and you're getting 8 different shades. Like, honestly, that is such a bargain, and they're so pigmented and just amazing. And SOAP is the best person to go to for highlight advice because it's a favorite makeup product, so the fact that she's brought out a palette just proves that they're going to be good. So yeah, definitely keeping those two palettes because I do wear them. Same goes with my new Tarte palette. This is the Tarteist Pro Glow palette. I absolutely love it, and it basically is just a contour and highlight palette. It also does have a cream contour, so if I do want to go for that, then I would probably reach for this palette more over those previous Pro Stro palettes. So yeah, honestly, I absolutely love this, and I'm now addicted to Tarte and want every single product. So yeah, also, can we just appreciate this packaging? It's like a matte packaging. It's really, really nice. So honestly, this is my new favorite thing. I absolutely love that. And then I have two of the Sleek highlighting palettes. I honestly just swear by these. Again, a good beginner palette. And I have the shade Solstice, which I'm not gonna lie, I don't really use as much, but it is super, super pretty. If I can show you without it all falling out. So I'm obviously just gonna keep both of these because I love them so much. This is the other one, if you're wondering. This one's Cleopatra's Kiss, and the one that I just use all the time. This is so, so pretty, and definitely up my street because I love a kind of bronzy goldy highlight. So definitely keeping those two as well. And then next I have this Revolution Bait highlighter. This is in the shade Rose Gold Lights. It is really nice, but I just don't think I'll ever wear this. It's more of a blush shade, but it is a highlighter, so it's really confusing like what you should use it as. But I just know I'm not going to wear it because I don't really wear this sort of pink color, so definitely going to pass that along. And I think like my sister or someone would want this anyway, so yeah, it's probably best if I give it to someone else. And then I also have my Too Faced Sweet Peach Glow palette. This is a contour, blush and highlight palette. It's absolutely stunning, and I just love the Too Faced Sweet Peach palettes because peach is one of my all-time favorite scents, so this is just right up my street, and I absolutely love this. And then next I have this Collection Blush and Glow palette. I think I'm gonna get rid of this now just because I have so many other palettes that I love, and I just never really use this. It is really good though, and I think it was like £5 or something, so yeah,
I'm going to pass this one along, but it is a really good palette because you're getting three different products in one, so it is really handy for traveling. And then next I have my two highlighters that I got in America, which, can I just say, are my new favorites. I am obsessed with these, especially the Physicians Formula Butter Highlighter. I've been wearing this literally every single day, and this is in the shade Champagne. It's just incredible, and if you can get your hands on it, then definitely do. And then I also have the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder. This one is in the shade, where does it say? Is it on the front? Oh yeah, Golden Flower Crown. This is also a really good one. And yeah, I'm just obsessed with those, honestly. My absolute favorites now. And then again, an absolute classic is the Balm Mary Luminizer. This was my first proper highlighter apart from the MUA ones, and I honestly just still love this to this day. As you can see, I've hit pan, so it shows how much I love it, and I definitely need to use it more because I tend to just stick to the Wet n Wild Physicians Formula now, but I'm definitely going to pick this one up again because it is just an absolute classic and an amazing one. And then next I have this L'Oreal True Match Highlight. I'm going to pass this one along just because it is a pink tone highlight, and as I said earlier, I don't really wear that sort of shade. This is in the shade Icy Glow, but it is really good product. I just don't really wear that sort of colour. So I'm going to put that one in the declutter pile. Okay, what else do I have here? I have the L'Oreal Infallible Sculpt Contouring Palette. Now this is a cream to powder kind of product, but I just never wear it, and as I said, I don't really like cream products. So I think I'm just going to pass this one along as well because there's no point me keeping it if I don't wear it, but it is a good one if you do like cream products. And then next I have this Sleek Contour Kit, an absolute favourite. If I ever go for a contour, it has to be this one, and I honestly just couldn't live without this. This was in the shade Light, and of course I just have to keep that. And then another favourite at the moment is this from L'Oreal. This is the Back to Bronze Bronzing Powder. This should actually be in my bronzing drawer. Why did I put this in this drawer? I'm not entirely sure. So I'm going to put this one aside into the pile of overspill and put this one in the pile of bronzers in a minute. And then next I have these two MUA highlighters, and I don't know what to do about these. I think I'm going to swatch them and then decide, because I haven't used them in a while, but they are really pretty, and for £3, these are just the best beginner highlighters. So this one's in the shade Golden Scintillation, so I'm just going to swatch that on my hand. I hope you can see it, but it is just this gold shade. And then the other one I have is called Pearlescent Sheen, and this one, as the name suggests, is basically just like a pure pearl shade, but it has this like rainbow blue undertone, and it's very, very different to any other highlighters I've tried before, but it is just so intense. Like, this is what it looks like. So I don't really know what to do. I think I might keep the gold one for now. Oh, I don't know. I really don't know what to do, guys. Okay, I've decided I'm going to keep them for now just because they are super pretty. And then if I don't use them in the next couple of months, then I will declutter these ones as well. But honestly, I just can't part with these at the minute because they are such like different shades as well. And then next I have two highlighters from Aloha Glitz. Obviously keeping these. If you don't know what Aloha Glitz is, then basically my internet best friend Liv has her own brand called Aloha Glitz. And I will link the website and also the Instagram page down below so you can go and follow and check it out. But honestly, the products are amazing. They're really, really cheap as well. The eyeshadows are only £2, and I can't remember how much the highlights were, but they are really, really cheap. They're under £5 basically for each product, and they're just insane. And these are the shades Chloe and Champagne Twist. And although I said I don't really like pink highlights, this one is so different. It's more of a kind of blush shade, and yeah, it's just so, so pretty. So I definitely will be keeping both of those, and definitely check them out because I know she'd appreciate it. And then next I have my NYX powder blush in the shade Taupe. This used to be my all-time favorite contour. It still is one of my favorites, but I just don't use it as much, so I'm gonna keep it because I know I just love it, and I will definitely bring it back out again and make some use of it because it's so, so good and like the perfect shade for contour. And then next I have this Barry M Flawless Cheeks Contour Kit. I think I'm gonna pass this one along as well because I just never wear this. As you've seen, I have so many other contour palettes, so yeah, I'm gonna put this one in the declutter pile. And then I also have this other contour kit, which is from Revlon. This is the Sculpt and Highlight Contour Kit. I don't think I've ever actually used this, so I'm going to keep it because I want to give it a go. And out of all the other contour kits I've shown that I've decluttered, I think this is the one that's more me, and it is super, super pretty. So I'm going to keep this one because I just feel like I need to keep one. So yeah, definitely going to keep that and give it a go, and I'll try and let you know what I think of it. And then next I have this Collection contour kit. What do I think about this one? So this one is a good one, so I might keep it for now, and then again, if I don't use it in a couple of months, I will declutter that one too. And then next I have this Revlon, what is this called? This is the Shimmer Brick in the shade Rose Gold. I'm going to swatch it for you to show you what it looks like. So I'm going to do a swatch of all of the shades because it's honestly insane. Oh, it's not even picking up on camera. It's so, so pretty and so iridescent. Like, honestly, this is so nice, and I've kind of just ruined the pattern, but I'm definitely keeping that because it's just so good, and it is a good dupe for the Bobbi Brown Shimmer Bricks. So yeah, that's always a good one. And then the last thing I have is this Benefit Girl Meets Pearl. Don't think I've ever used this either, so I'm just going to swatch it on my hand, but I'm pretty sure, yeah, it's pink. Yeah, I'm going to declutter this as well because it is a pink toned, and as I said, don't really wear that many pink tones, so I'm going to declutter that one as well. Even though it's Benefit, I just know I will never wear it. Guys, I've just had a change of thought. I'm going to keep the Barry M one and get rid of the Collection one just because there's more shades in it, and I feel like that is more me than this one, so I'm going to declutter this one instead. Okay, so this is the finished pile, and I think I've done a good job again. I feel like I have got rid of so much stuff, and this is literally overflowing, so I think I'm gonna have to try and take some stuff out in a minute if it gets too full. But yeah, I feel like this is such a big difference, and I'm gonna try and fit it all into the drawer now, and I'm not sure whether the palettes are gonna fit, so I might have to put these separate, but we're gonna give it a go, and then I'll let you know what it looks like. Okay, so this is what the drawer now looks like, and then hopefully if there's room, I'm going to put these in my eyeshadow palette holder, which obviously I'll show you when I get to the eye product section, but if not, I'm going to have to put them in the top two drawers because these lift up. So yeah, I'm going to keep these out for now because they don't fit in this bit, but I'm honestly just so impressed, and I feel like it's just so much neater, and that makes me so happy. So yeah, that's another drawer done. Okay, so this is my bronzer and powder drawer, and I have a couple of products over here as well, which I'm just going to grab, because I might as well do that now. And then again, gonna take it all out, clean it all out, and start decluttering. Okay, so this is the pile of products, and again, just gonna start decluttering and put it into this box. And yeah, I'm excited for this drawer actually, because this is one of my favorites. Okay, so let's just get started. So the third thing I have is my L'Oreal Back to Bronze bronzing powder. As I mentioned when I did my highlight drawer, I'm obviously going to be keeping this because it's definitely my favorite bronzer at the moment, and I'm loving it. And then next I have this NYC Sunny Bronzer, and this was a massive trend, and I basically just bought this because everyone on YouTube was talking about it because it was like discontinued or something, and no one could get their hands on it. And I'm not gonna lie, like, it is an okay bronzer, but I just never wear it at all, so there's no point me keeping this one, and I'm gonna declutter it straight away. And then next I have the Mini Benefit Judith Hula bronzer. This is like their liquid bronzer, and I've actually used most of this up, so I'm going to declutter it because it's pretty much all gone now. And then next I have this Essence Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder. This bronzer is absolutely massive, but again, I never wear it, and I think it's just because of the size as well, because it's not very practical when you're traveling, so I am going to declutter this one as well. And then the same goes for this MUA Translucent Pressed Powder. This is really good because it is a pound, and if you are on a budget and you're looking for a powder, then this is definitely a good one to go for, but I just never use it and never reach for it, so there really is no point me keeping this one. And then as I said earlier, I have my favourite powder, which is the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Matte Powder, and I seem to have three of these. So I have the shades Beige, Sand Beige, and also Warm Vanilla. I feel like Warm Vanilla is going to be a bit too light, because if you compare it to these are definitely darker. I'm not sure if you can really tell, but I think I'm going to keep these two because this one is a bit lighter anyway. So yeah, and then I'm going to declutter the Warm Vanilla one. And then next I have the Rimmel Natural Bronzer, and although a lot of people like this, I just never really reach for it because, as I said earlier, I just reach for the same products. So I am going to declutter this one as well, just because there's no point me keeping this if I just never use it. And then next I have one of my other favourite bronzers, which is the Hoola Bronzer from Benefit. I've actually hit pan on this, which is so, so sad. And that's why I haven't used it in a while, because I don't want it to go. But honestly, this is one of the best bronzers out there, so definitely keeping that one. The same goes for the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. I got this when I was in America, and it's just so good. This is in the shade Deep Bronzer, and it smells incredible as well. And the packaging is just so nice, so of course, keeping that as well. And then next I have two loose powders. I have this this Kat Von D one, which is the Locket translucent setting powder. To be fair, I don't need two loose powders, do I? If I have the Kat Von D, I think I'm going to declutter this one, which is the LA Girl one. It is really good, but like I said, I don't need two, so definitely going to declutter that one as well. And then I have the Rimmel Stay Matte, which I'm going to keep because it is just an absolute classic and it's always useful to have. This one's in the shade Transparent, so yeah, going to keep that one. And then I'm going to declutter this Rimmel one, which is the Clear Complexion. Again, it's another good powder, but it has hit pan and I just never wear this one anymore. This one is also in the shade Transparent, so I definitely recommend those two Rimmel powders if you are looking for a powder because they are just absolute staples. And then I have this other Rimmel one here, which is the Insta Fix and Matte, which is the translucent powder. This is one of their new ones and it's like a white powder, so I'm definitely going to keep this because I haven't given it a go yet, and yeah, it's supposed to be really good, so I'm going to be keeping that one. And then I have another favorite bronzer here, which is from the Body Shop. This is the Honey bronzer and I just absolutely love this. It's the perfect shade and it's just such a nice formula, so definitely keeping that. And then I have this bronzing palette from Maybelline. This is another true favorite and I used this a lot last summer because, as you can see, it's hit pan. It does come with like a highlight on the end too, so this one is a good one to go for because it has this kind of contour shade here, and then the other two are more bronzy shades. And I have two products left, and the first one is the Bourjois chocolate bronzer, and I used to be obsessed with this, so I am going to keep it because it is just a really nice bronzer and it smells amazing. If you haven't smelt this, then I definitely do. It honestly does just smell of pure chocolate, so it is a good one. And then the last one is the Essence Sun Club shimmer bronzing powder. I don't really reach for this, but I think I might keep it because it is really pretty and I want to get more use out of it, so I'm going to force myself to use this. And if I don't use it again in a couple of months, then I will declutter this one as well. Okay, so this is the finished declutter and I'm really impressed with this again. I keep saying this after every single drawer, but honestly I'm so proud of myself because if you know me, you know that makeup is just a massive thing of mine, so to get rid of all of this is honestly just unbelievable. And yeah, this is all that's left and I'm gonna put it all back in the drawer and show you what it looks like. Okay, so this is the finished drawer. The Kat Von D powder didn't actually fit in there, so I am going to have to put that in one of the top drawers. This is the finished drawer and I'm just going to put it back in now, and honestly this drawer was so full when I took it out that it wouldn't really close properly and it struggled to fit in the gap, so the fact that I've decluttered it all now means that I won't have that issue and it means nothing will smash or break, and that honestly makes me the happiest person ever. It sounds really stupid, but it was really, really annoying me. Okay, and then the final drawer I have is my blush drawer. This is one of the most full as well, and it honestly struggles to shut, as did the bronzer one. So yeah, I'm really excited to start decluttering this because it honestly needs it so bad. And I also have this palette over here which I'm going to pop just next to it, and again going to get it all out and start decluttering. So let's just get started. So the first thing I have is my Urban Decay Naked Flush palette, and this one is in the shade Native. I really, really like this. I haven't actually used it in so long though, so I honestly need to bring this out so much more, so that's going to be my mission for the next couple of months. Definitely keeping this. And then next I have this Revolution Ultra Blush palette. This is in the shade Sugar and Spice, and I absolutely loved this for so, so long, and it comes with 8 different blush shades, and these ones are kind of highlight shades as well, and I honestly just never wear this anymore, and I just don't really reach for a full blush palette as like big as this when I'm going for a blush. So I will pass this one along and declutter it to someone else, probably my sister, as I mentioned earlier. And then next I have this other blush palette, which is from Sleek, but I am going to be keeping this one because it is so much smaller and it just has such pretty colours, so I really, really like this one. This is the Blush by 3 in the shade Pink Lemonade. I've had this for a while, but honestly Sleek blushes are one of my favourites. And then speaking of Sleek, I have, how many others do I have? 3 others I think here. So I'm going to go through each of these and decide which ones I'm going to keep. So the first one I have is in the shade Flushed. So I'm just going to actually open them all up because I feel like that's going to be so much easier. Okay, so these are the 3 I have. So I have Rose Gold, Flushed. Which one's Flushed? This one's Flushed. And then also this one, which is called Pomegranate, and I think I'm going to declutter the Pomegranate one just because it is pretty dark, as you can see, and I don't think I'm going to wear it because it has an iridescent undertone as well, and yeah, I just don't think this one is really up my street, so I am going to declutter that one. And I think I might keep these other two because I think that Flushed is a really good good one for the winter time. And also rose gold is just a classic, and it's also a dupe for the NARS Orgasm Blush. So yeah, they're gonna keep those two and then declutter the other one. And then I also have three NYX blushes, which I don't really wear that often, so I'm going to go through these as well. So this first one is called Rose Garden, and it's practically the same as the Sleek Rose Gold one. So I'm definitely going to declutter that one because it's just so similar that I don't need both of them. And then I also have the shades Bittersweet, which is quite a dark shade, and also this one, which is called Desert Rose. Let me just swatch them. Okay, so that's what those two look like, if you can really tell. I think I'm gonna just, I don't know. I don't know if to keep this one because it is quite a different shade. So I'm gonna keep this one, which is called Bittersweet, and then I'm going to declutter the Desert Rose one because it is quite a vibrant pink and I don't really go for that, so yeah, gonna declutter two and then keep one. And then next I have my two MAC blushes, which I absolutely love. This one especially I love because it's just one of my all-time favorite blushes. This is in the shade Margin, and it just comes out a really nice neutral peachy nice glow, and yeah, I just honestly love this one so much. And then the other one I have is Dolly Mix, which is pretty vibrant, but I just like it for more out there looks. So I'm gonna keep both of these for now because I just love them so much. And then next I have my Benefit Rocketeur, another absolute favourite. I think this might be my absolute favourite, like, all-time blush, but I don't really know. I really like the MAC one as well. And yeah, of course, I just have to keep that. Same goes for this Urban Decay one. This is one of the Afterglow blushes in the shade Fetish. It's just such a pretty colour, and I really like the formula of this blush. And then next I have this Rimmel blush in the shade Santa Rose. I honestly just never wear this, so I'm going to declutter that one. And the same goes for this Makeup Revolution one, which is in the shade Now. This one is actually good because it's a pound, and honestly it's really pigmented, but I just never wear it, so there's no point me keeping this one. And then next I have two Milani blushes, and I have Luminoso, which is just one of my all-time favourites as well. Definitely keeping that one. And then I also have this one in the shade Berry Amour. I think I'm going to declutter this because, again, I just never wear it. So I'm going to declutter this one as well. And then next I have my Too Faced Sweetheart blush. I think that's what it's called. Definitely keeping this. It's really, really pretty, but I need to wear it more. Like, honestly, I just don't wear it enough, so I'm definitely going to bring that out, as well as all the other products I said to wear in the next couple of months. And then I also have the Soap and Glory Peach Party. I really, really love this. It's really pretty. This one's in the shade Apricot Jam, and it's kind of similar to the concept of a shimmer brick. It's just really nice to swirl all together and just gives you a really nice glow for the summer. Oh, I've also found another Sleek blush. This one's in the shade Terracotta. I think I might keep this one as well because it's more of a bronzy glow. So I think this is a good one to go for if you want something a bit more neutral. And then next I have this 17 blush. I honestly just never wear this. This is in the shade Plum Puff. It is a really nice colour though, but I just don't wear it. And then I'm going to keep my L'Oreal Blush Sculpt because I need to wear this more as well. This is in the shade Nude Beige, but it is really nice because you're getting three different shades. And again, it's more of a kind of peachy terracotta type colour, which I really, really like. So I definitely recommend this. And then I have my two first, I say first, but they're not necessarily my first because I feel like I've been given some before this, but these are my first like proper purchases by myself. And these are the Natural Collection blushes. I just absolutely loved these. And my favorite was definitely Pink Cloud, but I just know that I would never wear this sort of bright pink shade again. So I am going to declutter that one. And what's this one? This one's in the shade Dusky Pink. I'm going to do a quick swatch of it because it does look a really nice color. I'm not too sure on this one either, actually. It looked a lot darker, but it does come out a lot lighter on your hand. So I'm just going to declutter this one as well because there's no point me keeping it if I don't wear it. And then next I have this Too Faced blush. Not Too Faced, why did I say Too Faced? I meant Topshop, in the shade Dream Phone. I really like this blush, so definitely keeping that one. And then the last thing I have is this Ciate with Olivia Palermo like duo set. And this is a blush and bronzer, and I really, really like this. And it is limited edition, I'm pretty sure. So I'm gonna keep this for now as well. And the packaging is so cool. It's kind of this like snake skin type print, and yeah. So this is going in the keep pile. Okay, so this is the pile of things that I'm keeping. There is quite a lot here, but honestly, I just love all these products, so I can't really declutter any more. And as you can see, this box is getting pretty full anyway, so I couldn't really fit much more. But I am honestly just so happy, and yeah, I just can't believe that this is me. Like, honestly, if you told me I'd get rid of this much makeup, then I just wouldn't believe you. So I'm gonna put this back in the drawer, and then I'm gonna show you a whole overview of everything that I've decluttered. Okay, so this is all back in the drawer. It honestly looks so much better. So I'm really happy, and hopefully, I'm gonna test it now, it fits back in. Okay, so this is the final declutter box for everything that I'm getting rid of in my face drawers. And honestly, I'm so proud of myself, as I've already said so many times, but this is honestly just such a lot of stuff. Like, I don't really know if you can see how much stuff this actually is, but this is probably like a whole new makeup collection in itself. So yeah, I'm really excited to give these to family and friends and other people that will use them, because I just know that I'm not going to use them and not going to love them. So I might as well give them to someone else who will. I will in a second show you all of the drawers complete, so you can see the before and after. Okay, so this is an after shot of all the drawers. Again, it's quite hard to show you, but I feel like you can see the difference massively, and I just can't wait to like delve into my makeup collection now, because it's so much easier to find everything that I want, and I just know that everything I love is in one place. So I'm so happy that I did this declutter, and I really hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope that you want to continue to watch my other ones, because I will be doing my eye drawers next, and then finally my lip products. If you did enjoy it, please give it a massive thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe down below, and just give this video lots of love, because I would appreciate it so much, and I will see you soon in my next video. Bye!